Hi there, I'm Christina Halstead, and this is a quick tutorial about how to use shape tools. Basically, shape tools run pretty much similar to the pencil tool, where you have a central line going through your stroke, and you can change that after you've drawn it with the select tool, which is the black arrow. What I'm going to show you here is how to use the other tools that work similar. In this case, line tool, which is pretty self-explanatory. You have a line that can be built upon. And I don't know if you can see, but what happened here was these two lines were very close together, so they actually, their strokes actually link together because I have this selected. If you don't want that to happen, whereas basically you can pull them around, they're still somewhat attached by a stroke. If you don't want that to happen, you can go ahead and unclick that. And the next one is the rectangle, which is exactly what it sounds like. It makes a rectangle. And you see that it actually auto-filled here to the same black color as the line, because for this, I have this little box here ticked, which is the autofill. If you turn that off, your box will just be the line whose thickness can be altered with that little parameter right there. If you want to make a perfectly square rather than a rectangle, hold down shift and drag your cursor out, and you'll see that it's always going to be a box. You can get your box, and then you can also, if you let go of shift, it'll go back to following your cursor and make a more rectangular shape. Another thing about the box tool is that when you go into the contour editor, which again is this little white triangle here, you can move your four corners around, because it's still just like the line, everything has a contour point, and you can just move them around. The third shape in the shape tool is the ellipse. Much like the square, just drag it out and it'll be an oval or a circle, depending on if you're holding down shift, you'll get your perfect circle, let go of shift, you'll get your oval. Now, unlike the square, you don't really have one control point or four control points. You have many control points. Usually it's pretty even, and you can actually just go ahead and pull those out. And just like the pencil tool, if you double click on those points, you'll get handlebars that'll let you reshape the line based on a curve. And also, just like the line, you can go into the select tool and alter your shape using the control points on the select tool, which just kind of highlights the entire area which it controls. And you can move it around, you can skew it by putting the cursor on the line. You'll get a little up and down arrow or a side to side arrow, and that's how you skew. If you want to rotate it, you just go outside one of the four corners and push and pull around until you get that little circle right there. And that's basically how you can alter any of these when you have the select tool activated. The last one is the polyline. And basically you can do straight lines with that, but usually that's if you go from one point to the other. Normally if you make a point and then drag, you'll get the handlebars for your control point, which means you can turn it into a curve instead of a straight line. Can actually link it back up too. And if you wanted, you can always delete extra points, of course, by either using the contour tool as just double tapping on one, or you can actually select a group and delete them. Of course, that'll drastically alter your line, and anywhere the lines cross, you're going to get a new contour point. So be aware that that will happen if you have two lines come together like that. And that is it for the other shapes that have the same kind of parameters as the pencil.